Hello everybody, my name is Vinay Jacob John. Please visit my gospel website jesushealsministries.org. Also visit my friend's website, Evangelist Jesse Duplantis. His website is www.jdm.org. Brother Jesse Duplantis was taken to heaven one day by Jesus, and he meets Jesus and he sees Jehovah sitting upon the throne in God's throne room. Please, Jesse Duplantis wrote a book called Heaven, God, Heaven, Close Encounters of the God Kind. This is, today we're going to read from chapter 9 of the same book, Heaven, Close Encounters of the God Kind. Chapter 9, I saw God's throne. I felt weaker and weaker as we approached the throne room. It looked to me like millions of people were there. Looking around, I saw 24 empty seats near the throne. I said, I've read in the scriptures about the 24 elders. Revelation 4:4. Those are their seats. Where are they? Jesse, your servants here, David told me, as he had earlier. They're out in the city and in paradise, blessing and helping people. We help people here. Everyone serves. Somebody is always trying to do something for you. Someone will always ask, what can I do for you? Even the flowers turn toward you in an attitude of service. They turn and look at you. They don't have eyes, but they know you're there. And you can't smash them. They go through your legs. I would look down at a flower I had stepped on and think, why didn't I smash it? You can't kill anything there. There's no destruction. After seeing the way everyone served each other in heaven, I don't think God is looking for brilliant individualists. I believe He's looking for team players. I remember the account in the Bible when James and John, the sons of Zebedee, asked Jesus how they could have a special place in heaven. In Mark 10, verses 43, 44, 45, Jesus explains, but whosoever will be great among you shall be your minister. And whosoever of you will be the chiefest shall be servant of all. For even the Son of Man, Jesus, came not to be ministered unto, but to minister and to give your life, Jesus, a ransom for us all. Thank you, Jesus, for giving us your life, a ransom for us all. Angels were praising God. There were several big angels with wings flying around the room. They were huge. Their faces were distinctive, as though carefully chiseled. They looked like they had a 30-foot wingspan. The angel with me didn't have wings. He looked just like a human being. The closer I got to the throne of God, the weaker I became because of the glory of God. When people are coming to the throne, you see God's anointing on them, that glory on them from the different levels. But when you get to the throne, nothing compares to the glory of God, Jehovah, Jesus, Holy Spirit. When the light from the throne hit me, I couldn't stand up. I fell down, and the angel gave me more of the fruit, saying, eat this so you can stand the glory of God. I ate it, but my knees had just buckled. I stayed on the floor. Everyone else was standing up. For a lack of a better way of putting it, when you stand or fall at the throne, God's glory washes out your glory. His glory goes in you and on you. Everything in heaven is beautiful. The floor looked like marble with gold in it, gold threads or veins running through the marble. Although I couldn't look up for very long at a time, I looked up from the floor in the direction of the overwhelming light and I saw Him. I saw Elohim, Jehovah God, Yahweh, sitting on the throne, but I saw His feet, only His feet. The light was so bright that came from Him, I couldn't see His face. Now I know why the scripture says we can't see Jehovah's face and live. At least I knew I couldn't. I had to keep looking down. The light was so intense. But I looked again and I saw the lower part of His hand resting on the arm of the throne. He is so big, you can't describe Him in a dimension. His hand is huge. His body, the form of it, is sort of like energy, spirit. There's a wall around the throne, but the throne is higher than the wall. That's why you can see the throne from every direction, from a distance. And that power, that energy like smoke of God, covers all around the chair of the throne itself. I heard a sound, whoosh, there was a massive amount of energy in that place. That's the only way I can explain it. It was God's power. You hear that noise, then the energy goes back into Him. There is smoke and power and noise. The place is noisy and angels are hollering. The angels with wings were circling the throne, singing and shouting, "The great God Jehovah." Every time they circled the throne, they praised God because they saw a new facet of Him they had never seen before. And they expressed what they see by saying, "Holy, holy, holy." That's how vast God is. Even though the angels have been flying around God's throne since the beginning of their existence, they are still seeing new revelations of His character, His love, and His glory. There was a cloud that looked like smoke going up from the throne, and I heard that massive sound, whoosh. It was power like I've never experienced in my life. Then I saw God's finger barely move, and when it moved, an angel that was flying near Him was thrown up against the wall. Bam! It didn't hurt the angel, but I felt him. God just barely moved. A universe could be annihilated. This is part one of today's reading from Evangelist Jesse Duplantis' book, Heaven, Close Encounters of the God Kind. Then our next video will be the rest of the same chapter, chapter 9, I Saw God's Throne. Thank you for listening to me today. Jesus loves us all, Jesus heals us all, Jesus provides for us all, always, in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Amen.